Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Fluid Mechanics and Machines. This is lecture number 14.1, 14th chapter, first lecture on hydraulic turbines. So, in this lecture series, 14.14, chapter 14, we are going to discuss about the hydraulic turbines. The topic for this lecture, classification of turbine, head and efficiency, heads and efficiency of turbine, velocity triangle, axial, radial, mixer flow turbines and Pelton wheel. And in the earlier lecture, we discussed about the impact of jet, centrifugal pump and reciprocating pump. So, the hydraulic machines, impact of jet we have discussed, and we have discussed the efficiency and power requirement of the centrifugal pump and reciprocating pump. And the learning outcome for this lecture, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to define hydraulic turbine, explain the working of the Pelton turbine, calculate the power and efficiency of the Pelton turbine. Hydraulic turbine is a power producing turbo machine which produces mechanical power from hydraulic energy of water, which is used to run the electrical generator to produce electric power. So, in the earlier chapter also, we discussed the centrifugal pump and reciprocating pump. So, the centrifugal pump and reciprocating pump, they are power absorbing machines. They absorb the power and raise the head of the water. But the hydraulic turbine, it is working on the opposite direction. It takes the hydraulic energy, it converts the hydraulic energy into mechanical power. So, the centrifugal pump and the hydraulic turbine, they are turbo machines, rotating type of machines. But the reciprocating pump is working on the reciprocating principle. So, the hydraulic turbine is a power producing turbo machine, rotating machine, which produces mechanical power from the hydraulic energy of water, which is used to run the electrical generator to produce the electrical power. So, we classify the turbine based on the different parameter. We classify the turbines. The first classification based on the action of water, according to the action of water on the moving blade, this may be impulse turbine or reaction turbine. The example for impulse turbine is Pelton turbine and the reaction turbine is Francis turbine. According to the head of water available, what is the head of water? At what height the water is available? So, high head turbine, above 250 meters. So, if the head is above 250 meters, it is called as high head turbine. Normally, for high head applications, we are using the Pelton turbine. Medium head turbine, 60 to 250 meters height. For example, so we are using the Francis turbine for medium head turbine. And low head turbine, so when the head is very low, less than 60 meter, then we are using the Kaplan turbine. So, based on the selection of the turbine, also based on the head available with head of the water available. And according to the flow direction, there are four different types of the turbine: tangential flow turbine, radial flow turbine, axial flow turbine and mixed flow turbine. So, tangential flow turbine, the flow direction is tangent to the path of the rotation of the runner. So, there will be a rotating element, rotor or runner. So, the direction of the water flow, is tangential to the runner rotation, that is called, for example, we are using the Pelton turbine is a tangent, it is an example for tangential flow turbine. Radial flow turbine, the flow direction is in radial direction, flow direction is radial direction and the perpendicular to the axis of the turbine. There are two types of radial turbine, inward radial flow turbine. For example, Francis turbine, Thomson turbine and the Grad radial flow turbine. And outward radial flow turbine, Fernieron turbine is an example for outward radial flow turbine. Among the radial flow turbine, the Francis turbine is popularly used. Axial flow turbine, in axial flow turbine, the water flows parallel to the axis of the runner. For example, propeller turbine or Kaplan turbine and the Kaplan turbine. Both are very much used in the practical field. Kaplan turbine is very popular. Propeller turbine is also used. Mixer flow turbine. In mixer flow turbine, water enters the runner at the outer periphery in the radial direction and leaves it at the center of the center in the direction parallel to the axis of the runner. So the water enters radially and leaves axially. This is called as mixed flow turbine. The modern Francis turbine, they are mixed flow turbines. Then according to the specific speed of the turbine, specific speed one of the important design parameter for the turbine. We'll define the specific speed in the later stage. So the specific, based on the specific speed, so this may be low specific speed ranging from 8.5 to 30. We will be using Pelton turbine. Medium specific speed varying from 50 to 340. We are using Francis turbine is the example. High specific speed varying from 255 to 860. Kaplan turbine is the example. So this number you have to remember. So low specific speed, medium specific speed, or high specific speed. Because in any of the competitive examination, they will ask this question. So they will give the specific speed range, and they will give the type of the Pelton turbine. For type of the turbine, you have to match or you have to identify the proper range of the specifics for specific speed for a particular type of turbine. And according to the disposition of the shaft, this may be vertical shaft turbine or horizontal shaft turbine. And so these are all the classification. So next topic will be head of the hydraulic turbine. The head acting on the turbine may be defined in two ways. One is cross head, another one is net head. So the cross head is defined as the difference between the head raised level and the tail raised level when no water is flowing. This is also known as static head or the total head. So the level difference, head raise is the level of water available in the dam. Tail raise, the level of water available in the, in the draft tube. So that is what the static head or the grass head. Net or effective head. The effective head is the head available at the entrance of the turbine. It is obtained by subtracting all the losses of head in the total head. So the total head is H1 and we subtract the head loss due to the friction. So when the water is flowing through the pipeline from the head race to the turbine, there will be frictional losses. So we have to subtract all the frictional losses. That is what the net or effective head. So the net head or the effective head equal to the gross head or the static head minus the head loss due to the friction. HF is the head loss due to the friction. For impulse turbine, H equal to P1 by W plus V1 square by 2G plus Z1 minus Z2, where 1 is the inlet of the turbine, 2 is the outlet of the turbine. So, P1 by W is the pressure head, V1 square by 2G is the velocity head, and Z1 is the datum head, and Z2 is the height at the level of the turbine. And for reaction turbine, P1 by W plus V1 square by 2G plus Z1 minus Z2 plus V2 square by 2G. That is what the head available, the net head available for the reaction turbine. So, 1 is the inlet of the turbine, 2 is the outlet of the trap tube. Now, we will look at the Pelton turbine. And the Pelton turbine, so these are all the components, important components in the turbine. We have a runner, so a shaft and runner. On the outer periphery of the runner, we have the buckets. So, this is called as vans or the buckets. And this is what the real runner. So, the buckets are bolted on the runner. So, this is this hole is for the shaft. So, we insert the shaft here with the proper mechanical fitting. And the water, so we have a jet. So, this is the penstock. So, from where the water, from the head race, from the dam, the water is entering through the penstock to the turbine. At the end of the penstock, we have a nozzle. So, the nozzle opening, we have a small opening here at the tip of the nozzle. So, now the opening is controlled is by this pier. So, you can exploded view, you can look at here. This is the penstock, this is the nozzle, and this is the pier. By rotating the wheel, the pier can move forward or backward. So, when you move the backward, so there will be more quantity of water flow. When you move the pier, when you rotate the wheel and move the pier in the forward direction, it will partially close the nozzle. So, the amount of water flow to the turbine will reduce. So, depending on the working condition, depending on the power to be produced by the runner, so the spear position is changed by the wheel. And the jet is produced. The jet of water, it is impinging on the bucket. it is hitting the bucket which makes the runner to rotate in this anti-clockwise direction, and we have a casing. So the casing is the outer cover. So the casing, the main purpose of the casing is to avoid accident and to avoid the splash of water to the outside environment. And the bucket, look at the bucket. So you have hemispherical shape. So two hemispherical shape bucket, and the center we have the metal part. So the water hits at the center and deflected in both direction. So here this is the center of the bucket. The water jet is striking at the center and deflecting in both direction, and this is the small opening where the water is entering. And the next diagram, look at the diagram here. So this is the bucket wheel. So the jet of water is impinging at the center of the bucket, and which makes the runner to rotate. And using the, actually this is a small demonstration. So the runner is rotating, which is connected to electrical generator, which is producing electricity, and the bulb is illuminated. And look at this animated diagram. So this is again, look at here, the water is, jet of water is entering here and flowing to the both side, and it is leaving to the through the gap between the adjacent buckets. So this is how the Pelton turbine is working. And the, we have to calculate, what is the work done, what is the power output, and what is the efficiency of the Pelton turbine. We do all the calculations here. So for that, this is the bucket. Again, this is the center portion of the bucket where the water is hitting and it is deflected on both directions. So this is what the diagram. So this is the center line. The jet of water is hitting here and it is getting deflected. And the V1 is the velocity of the water at the entry of the Pelton wheel. So V1 is the velocity, and the Pelton wheel is rotating about the axis by the peripheral speed U1. U1 is the peripheral speed and V1 is the absolute velocity. And the vectorial sum of U1 and V1 is the VR1, relative velocity at the inlet. And the VW1 is equal to V1, which is the tangential velocity, velocity in the tangential direction, because this is the tangential flow turbine. So the absolute velocity is equal to the tangential velocity at the inlet. Now the water is hitting at the center and it is getting deflected. So the water is leaving with the relative velocity VR2 with the angle pi. So pi is the outlet angle of the bucket, outlet angle of the bucket. And actually the V2 is actually, now here we have the U2 is the peripheral speed at the outlet. So the vectorial sum of VR2 and U2 is the V2, the absolute velocity of the water. The absolute velocity, it will make an angle of beta with the outlet, with the horizontal direction. And the V2 has got two components. One is VW2 and VF2. So VW2 is the tangential component. VF2 is the flow direction. Flow direction, the velocity in the VF2 is the velocity in the flow direction. So the outlet velocity triangle and the inlet velocity triangle. So inlet velocity triangle is just a straight line for the Pelton turbine. You have to remember the outlet velocity triangle. Now from the inlet velocity triangle, we can conclude velocity of the jet equal to V1 equal to square root of 2gh. So h is the head of water available. The head will be given, you have to calculate V1. So V1 equal to square root of 2gh. And the peripheral speed, U1 equal to U equal to pi dn by 60. So U1 equal to U2 equal to pi dn by 60. So V1 equal to VW1. So VR1 equal to V1 minus U. So because you look at here, V1 equal to VW1, U1 plus VR1 equal to VW1, so VR1 equal to V1 minus U. From outlet velocity triangle, U2 equal to U, which is pi dn by 60, so VW2 equal to VR2 cos phi minus U. So VW2, this VW2 equal to the entire length is VR2 cos phi minus U2, so that is what, VR2 cos phi minus U, so U2 equal to U. Now the force exerted in the direction of motion of the runner. So the force equal to mass in the change in the velocity. So the mass equal to rho A, density into area into velocity. That is the mass of the fluid, mass of the water entering into the turbine runner, meeting the turbine runner from the nozzle. So rho A into velocity is the, rho A V is the mass of the water, mass of the liquid. Change in velocity, so the viral velocity at the inlet minus viral velocity at the outlet. So viral velocity at the inlet is VW1, viral velocity at the outlet is VW2, but in VW2 is in the opposite direction, That is why we have a negative sign. So this becomes rho A V1 into V W1 plus V W2. So the net work done by the jet on the runner per second, or the power produced by the runner, equal to Fx, the axial, the Fx is the force in the direction of the runner, into U, the peripheral speed. So rho A V1 into V W1 plus V W2 into U. This is in watts or joules per second. And there are different types of losses in the Pelton turbine. Head loss in the penstock, head loss in the nozzle, hydraulic losses due to the blade friction, eddy formation, energy contained by the water leaving the draft tube, or leakage losses. Mechanical losses are bearing and the frictional losses. These are all the different losses occurring. So to account all the losses, we define the efficiency of the turbine. The first efficiency is hydraulic efficiency of the turbine. The hydraulic efficiency equal to work done per second divided by kinetic energy of the jet per second. So work done equal to, we calculated work done equal to rho A V1 into V W1 plus V W2 into U divided by kinetic energy of the jet equal to mass half m v square. So half 1 by 2 m equal to rho A V1, and V1 square is the velocity square. So kinetic energy of the jet equal to half m v square. So 1 by 2 rho A V1 into V1 square. Now you calculating the simplifying, this will become, so rho A is getting cancelled, V1 is getting cancelled. So the 2 will go to the, 1 by 2 will go to the numerator, 2 will go to the numerator, 2 into VW1 plus VW2 into U divided by V1 square. So the hydraulic efficiency equal to 2 into VW1 plus VW2 into U is the peripheral speed divided by V1 square. Where now we take V1 equal to VW1, VR1 equal to V1 minus U. And for frictionless flow in the bucket, so when there is no friction in the bucket, so VR1 equal to VR2, which is V1 minus U. So this VW2 equal to VW1 equal to V1, and VW2 equal to VR2 cos phi minus U, which is V1 minus U cos phi minus U. Now you substitute for VW1 and VW2 in the equation. So hydraulic efficiency equal to 2 into V1 plus V1 minus U cos phi minus U into U divided by V1 square. So this V1, this minus U is combined. So V1 minus U plus V1 minus U cos phi U divided by V1 square. So 2U into V1 minus U is a common term. It is taken outside. 2U into V1 minus U into 1 plus cos phi divided by V1 square. The efficiency will be maximum for the given value of V1. So the V1, for U1 is the jet of water. The velocity of the water at the inlet, and U is the peripheral speed. So the when d by du of actually d by du of hydraulic efficiency with respect to differentiating this equation with respect to U and equating to 0. So the velocity V1, jet velocity is constant. Keeping the jet velocity constant, we have to optimize the runner speed. Angle of the bucket angle is also we keep constant. So, differentiating d by du of 2u into v1 minus u into 1 plus cos phi divided by v1 square. So, here 1 plus cos phi, 2 into 1 plus cos phi divided by v1 square is a constant. It is taken outside. So, 2 into 1 plus cos phi divided by v1 square, and d by du of u into v1 minus u equal to 0. So, differentiating this value becomes 0. So, differentiating this value, d by du of u into v1 minus u equal to 0. So, differentiating, this will become V1 minus 2U equal to 0, or U equal to V1 by 2. So, for maximum efficiency, this is the condition. So, what is the condition? Look at the condition. The peripheral speed, bucket speed, the peripheral speed U equal to 1 by 2, 50% of half of the velocity of the jet. So, when the peripheral speed is equal to half of the velocity of the jet, the efficiency will be maximum. Now, you take the hydraulic efficiency of Pelton turbine will be maximum when the peripheral speed is half of the velocity of the jet at the inlet. Now, the maximum efficiency, you substitute the maximum efficiency, we substitute the value of U here. So, 2 into V1 by 2 into V1 minus V1 by 2 into 1 plus cos phi divided by V1 square, and it will be maximum value equal to 1 plus cos phi divided by 2. So, the maximum efficiency, maximum hydraulic efficiency of the Pelton turbine equal to 1 plus cos phi divided by 2, and the condition for maximum efficiency equal to U equal to V1 by 2. So, V1 is the velocity of the jet, U is the peripheral speed. So, you have to remember U equal to V1 by 2. and mechanical efficiency of the Pelton turbine. So mechanical efficiency is the ratio of power available at the turbine shaft to the power developed by the runner. So the it will take care of the frictional losses in the runner shaft. There will be end bearing. The frictional losses are accounted by the mechanical efficiency. So mechanical efficiency equal to power available at the turbine shaft divided by power produced by the runner. And the overall efficiency is the product of these two. So overall efficiency equal to power available at the turbine shaft divided by the net power supplied to the turbine at the entrance. So this is the product of hydraulic efficiency into mechanical efficiency. Overall efficiency equal to hydraulic efficiency into mechanical efficiency. And the working proportion in the design of the Pelton turbine. So we have to follow certain condition for the design of the Pelton turbine. Velocity of the jet is given by V1 into CV into square root of 2GH. So CV is the velocity coefficient of velocity of the nozzle. We have to use the constant value 0.98 or 0.99. So H is the net head of the turbine. And the velocity of the wheel, U equal to pi into square root of 2GH. So where pi is the speed ratio, the value of the speed ratio varies from 0.43 to 0.48. And the angle of the deflection of jet is taken as 165 degree, if the value is not given. So the pi value we have to take 165 degree if the value is not given in the problem. The mean diameter of the or the pitch diameter of the runner is given by d equal to 60 u divided by pi n. So u equal to pi d n by 60. So from that you have to calculate the diameter of the runner or mean diameter of the runner. And the jet ratio is defined as the ratio of pitch diameter to the diameter of the jet. So m equal to capital D by small d. Small d is the diameter of the jet and capital D is the diameter of the runner. And width of the bucket equal to 5 times the diameter of the jet. And depth of the bucket equal to 1.2 times the diameter of the jet. And number of buckets is given by z equal to 15 plus capital D by small 2d. So capital D is the diameter of the runner. And the small d is the diameter of the jet. Or this equal to 15 plus 0.5 into m. M is the jet ratio. And the number of jet obtained by dividing total flow rate through the turbine by the rate of flow through a single jet. So if you have multiple jets in the Pelton turbine, in that case we have to calculate number of jet. When you have more amount of water flow in the case of Pelton turbine, then we have to calculate the number of jets required to run the rotor of the Pelton wheel. So we have to calculate the number of jet, that is equal to total flow rate divided by flow rate per jet. So these are all the working proportion of the Pelton turbine. So in the design or calculation of the Pelton turbine, we have to calculate all the parameter. If the question is a general design of the Pelton turbine, we have to calculate all the parameter. Or if they are asking the efficiency or the power output specifically, then you have to calculate the efficiency or the power output of the turbine. You have to remember all the calculations, all the equations for calculating the different parameters, then you have to solve the problem. In the next lecture, maybe we will solve problems on the Pelton turbine, so which will make you to understand the concept in a better way. So we stop here. So these are all the books I published in the mechanical engineering subject. And here you may find the book Fluid Mechanics and Machinery, which you can refer for further information. And I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures of the subject, all the subjects mentioned here, and the solutions for the gate question papers also uploaded in the YouTube channel. You can refer to it, subscribe the channel, use the video lectures. It is free of cost for your better learning and pass in the gate examination. So thank you for watching. So you please post your comments on the comments box, you subscribe the channel, and you can write to my mail ID for any clarification on the subject. I will meet again in another video lecture in the hydraulic turbines.